This spring, I was blessed with the opportunity to participate and try out for the Nigerian national team in Atlanta, Georgia. And it was the first scrimmage of the camp, literally like week one. And I get a layup, and as I'm running back down the court, like I have so much adrenaline because I'm like, I'm finally in the game, like I just scored a layup. And a girl throws a pass, and I'm like, oh my gosh, yes, I can still get this. I go for the pass, and as I come down, like, I think I noticed the girl to the right of me, and that just caused me to turn my body in a weird way. And like I landed with my leg going this way, but my body was turning this way. So essentially my knee kind of went like this, and I fell. And then the trainer came out, the coaches came out, and the players were obviously around me. And I tried to stand up because I'm like, I'm fine. And I just could not even stand up. Like my leg just was not supporting my weight. So Dr. Mary, who was like our team's doctor, was like looking at my knee, and then I was like, okay, like be honest, like what is it? She's like, well, I think it's your ACL, and I just busted out into tears. Hard to hear because it was like I already tore my ACL for the other one, so like why is this happening again? I feel like I had such a strong bond with the team and like the coaches by then that like they weren't like even trying to like rush me out, but it was like the middle summer session too, so I was already in like a class that I was trying to take in Atlanta. Like I was doing homework every night, like just trying to like stay up to date with my schoolwork, but also like enjoy this amazing opportunity. So we decided that it would just be best for me to go home and like focus on my studies and focus on like what to do next. Pack up my stuff, like my teammates helped me pack, like that's how supportive, and they were always there. They're like, okay, we'll help you. Then I got home. My teammates were there, and I come in with crutches, and they're like, what the heck? My roommates, first of all, were so nice. I live in like a, I guess you can say it's like a townhouse with five roommates. And of course, my room's upstairs. So they like, once my mom left, they had to start helping me up and down the stairs. And they're like, hey, Shala, she's like half my size. And like, she like literally had to like, haul my leg over her shoulder to like help me down the stairs, like this poor little thing. Even like Maddie, she's my roommate, but she's on like the softball team, like had to like bring me food, and like my roommates are really helpful. And then my teammates started like bringing me gifts and like just making sure I was all right. If I needed a ride, they would be there like to support me or like, get me somewhere. And my cat was really helpful, Zara. She loves to cuddle, and I think she knew that I was like in pain, so she would literally just like cuddle on my neck or like lay in my stomach like while I slept, and just like she helped a lot too. I think by the end of the week, like of course I still had those thoughts like, oh, I have to get surgery and have to do this all over again, like this sucks, but I think like my positive attitude started to kick in and like kind of push away those negative thoughts more. And then I just started to realize that this really happened for a reason. Like school was so hard right now. There's no way I would have been able to like be able to like play basketball and like handle all these classes I'm in right now. And I think I really needed to just sit down and like watch the game, because I understood the game, but not as much as I'm starting to like understand it now. I think I'm really grasping like a lot of smaller details that I never noticed. And then I also think it's like helping me with my leadership, because it wasn't that great in my opinion before this. And I think Coach A did a good job with making sure that I was like still involved and like wasn't like too worried about myself, but worried about my teammates. And she was always like, okay, Nick, like, are you talking? Nick, are you clapping? Nick, are you cheering? Like, Nick. Like, I was still in it. So now I'm really having to step up and learn how to be a leader for like my teammates off the court as opposed to on the court. And there are just so many like small pros like that I found from it that over like kicked away the con.